We are into the concept of signed measures. So if you look at the definition, the signed measure on the measurable space XB, we mean an extended real valued function, say gamma, defined for the sets B, that is, it is a mapping from B to R union minus infinity infinity, satisfying these three conditions. So for the first, it assumes at most one of the values, plus infinity minus infinity. So it assumes at most one of the values, plus infinity minus infinity, and the measure of that set is zero, and along with it is satisfying countably additiveness. So the equality in this in the sense, if this series converges absolutely if this is finite and it properly diverges otherwise. So this series converges absolutely if this is finite, else it properly diverges. So we have these three conditions. So for the first, we have it must assumes at most one of the values of them, and it is empty set, measure of empty set should be zero, satisfying countably additiveness. So we have it to be an extended real valued set function, as the mapping is as follows. So satisfying these three conditions to be the definition of signed measures. So having the concept of signed measures, you can also have a note that signed measures in general are not measures, but every measure is a signed measure. So signed measures in general is not a measure, but every measure is signed measure. You can have an example that the set R with the collection M and minus of Lebesgue measure. So set of all real numbers with the collection of Lebesgue measurable sets and defined minus M, it is a Lebesgue measure, is just a signed measure but not measure. So this is a signed measure but not in general a measure, which justifies our note. So this is the definition of signed measure. Next, we have three definitions to go through. One is of positive set, and what do you mean by negative set, and finally a null set. So we'll get into those definitions. We say that a set A is positive with respect to signed measure if A is measurable, and for every measurable subset E of A, we have signed measure of E to be greater than or equal to 0. So we say that a set A to be positive with respect to a signed measure if A is measurable, and for every measurable subset E of A, we have signed measure of E to be greater than or equal to 0. So again, A should be measurable, and for every measurable subset of E of A, we should have that to be greater than or equal to 0. So again, in the sense, if we need to see what do you mean by a negative set, we say that a set A is a negative. This will be a negative set. Again, we have the same thing with respect to signed measure. We say it is a negative set with respect to signed measure if A is measurable, and every measurable subset E of A, we have signed measure of E to be less than or equal to 0. So we have a negative set with respect to signed measure if that set is measurable, and for every measurable subset E of A, we have that to be signed measure to be less than or equal to 0. So these are the definitions of a positive set and a negative set. And by null set, we mean a set that is both positive and negative with respect to the signed measure is said to be null set. So a set which is both positive and negative with respect to the signed measure is said to be a null set. And we have some note on these measures. So a measurable set is a null set if and only if every measurable subset of it has a signed measure 0. So we call a measurable set is a null set if and only if every measurable subset of it has a signed measure 0. And in the next note, we have all measurable sets to be positive. So all measurable sets are positive, and speaking about countable sets, they are negative. So measurable sets are positive and countable sets, subsets are negative. So we have a lemma now, and we have two statements here in this lemma. Every measurable subset of a positive set is itself positive. So every measurable subset of a positive set is itself positive. And the next statement is the union of accountable collection of positive sets is positive. So the union of countable collection of positive sets is positive. So for the coming to the proof, the very first statement, every measurable subset of a positive set is itself positive, is trivially true. So the first statement is trivially true. So we are going to the next. So every measurable subset of a positive set is itself positive. So going to the next, we need to prove union of countable collection of positive sets is positive. So I will consider let A be the union of sequence ans of positive sets. So I am considering A to be the union of sequence ans of positive sets. If A is any measurable subset of A, if E is any measurable subset of A, I will define En to be as follow, which is E intersection An and intersecting with all other complements which I have considered in the sequence. So I am defining En to be the E intersecting with the nth and intersecting with all other complements of the elements of the sequence. So I have En to be like this, and clearly En is a measurable subset of An. So En is clearly a measurable subset of An, and so we have signed measure of En to be greater than or equal to 0. So since En's are disjoint and we have E to be the countable union of En's, since we need to prove union of countable collection of positive sets is positive, we have En's to be positive. So I am considering E to be the countable union of positive sets. So, and also since En's are disjoint, this is same as we have countably additiveness. So signed measures with summation countably additiveness, we have this to be greater than or equal to 0. That implies A to be a positive set. Again, if A to be a positive set, every measurable subset of A to be of signed measure greater than or equal to 0. So we have every measurable subset of A to be having signed measures greater than or equal to 0, which proves that A is a positive set. So this completes the lemma. For the next, we have an important lemma, and it states as follows: let E be a measurable set such that signed measure of E is positive and it is finite. So E is a measurable set such that signed measure of E is positive and it is finite. Then we need to prove that there is a positive set A, there is a positive set A contained in E with signed measure of A is positive. So we need to prove that there is a positive set contained in E with measure of signed measure of that A is positive. So looking into the proof, if E itself is a positive set, we are done. We are done because if E itself is a positive set, then by previous lemma, every measurable subset of positive set is positive. So that implies clearly the lemma. So if E is itself is a positive set, there is nothing to prove. So otherwise, if not, E contains sets of negative measure. So E contains sets of negative measure. It means there is a measurable subset E1 of E such that when signed measure of E1 is less than 0. So there is, if not, we, there is another measurable subset E1 of E with signed measure of E1 to be negative. So let N1 be the smallest positive integer such that signed measure of E1 is less than minus 1 by N1. So if not, we have E1 to be contained in E with signed measure of E1 to be less than 0. So I will have let N1 to be the smallest positive integer such that signed measure of E1 to be less than minus of 1 by N1. Then since signed measure of E1 is less than 0, it implies minus of signed measure of E1 is greater than 0, and we can have an N by Archimedean principle. We can have an N of the kind N times minus gamma of signed measure of E1 to be greater than 1. So again, if we are doing some simplifications, we are getting signed measure of E1 to be less than minus 1 by N. So by Archimedean principle, choosing N to be the smallest positive integer, I have signed measure of E1 to be less than now minus 1 by N. Then consider E minus E1. Again, if E minus E1 is a positive set, we are done. Because considering E minus E1, E can be expressed as a disjoint union of E1 and E minus E1. And since by our definition, measure of signed measure of E is positive. So signed measure of E is positive. So this side must be positive, but we have a subset E1 contained in E with signed measure negative. So signed measure of E1 is negative. As this side is positive, this to be negative, I must have signed measure of E minus E1 to be positive. So if I consider E minus E1, and if E minus E1 is of positive set, then we are done. Because this is a signed measure of positive measure with finite measure. So if E minus E1 is a positive set, again we are done. If not, if again E minus E1 is not a positive set, we will continue this process inductively. So if we not have A minus A1 to be positive set, and we will continue the process inductively, then there is a measurable subset E2 of E minus E1 with the signed measure of E2 to be negative. Let N2 be the smallest positive integer such that signed measure of E2 to be less than minus 1 by N2. And then consider E minus E1 union E2. In the previous step, we had considered E minus E1. Since E minus E1 was not positive, we will consider now E minus E1 union E2. Again, if E minus E1 union E2 is positive, we are through. If not, we will continue the process inductively, and in a K minus 1 step, we will be having a set E minus union of EIs I from 1 to K. And again, if it is not a positive set, let nk be the smallest positive integer for which there is a measurable subset ek such that ek is contained in e minus union of eis I from 1 to k minus 1. So that there is a measurable subset contained like this, and measure of ek is less than minus 1 by nk. And now I will set a to be e minus union ek. Now I am setting A to be E minus union EK, K referring from 1 to infinity, so that if A is E minus this, E will be A union of EKs. So after setting A to be E minus union EKs, we have E to be A union of EKs. And since this is a disjoint union, we have sine measure of E to be sine measure of A plus summation of sine measure of EKs. And we have this to be greater than 0, and we know that sine measure of e k's is less than 0 for every k, so that this is less than 0. Since if we need this to be positive, we must have this to be positive. So we have found a set A such that sine measure of A is positive, so that we are only remaining to prove that A is a positive set. And also note that sigma 1 by nk converges, because since sine measure of E is positive, also this is finite. Given that sine measure of A is positive and this is finite, we have, since sine measure of E case is less than or equal to 0 and this is greater than 0, we must have sine measure of A to be positive, that was we saw. But also we have summation of 1 by nk converges. This is because since sine measure of e case is less than 1 by nk by induction at the kth step, we have this to be convergent. By comparison test, we have this to be convergent implies summation of minus of gamma e case converges, so that we have gamma of A to be greater than 0, and this converges absolutely since gamma of E is finite. So if since sine measure is finite, we have the summation in the right to be absolutely convergent. So we are just ahead to prove that now gamma of A is a positive set. To prove that A is a positive set, given epsilon, since nk tends to infinity, we are free to choose k so large that 1 by nk minus 1 can be less than epsilon. So to prove that A is a positive set, given epsilon positive and nk tends to infinity, we are free to choose k so large such that 1 by nk minus 1 is less than epsilon. And we know that since A is containing E minus union EIs, A can contain no measurable set with measure less than minus 1 by nk minus 1, greater than minus epsilon. So A can contain no measurable set with measure less than 1 by 1 minus 1 by nk minus 1, which is greater than minus epsilon. So we will conclude that A contains no measurable sets of measure less than minus epsilon. So A contains no measurable sets which is of measure less than minus epsilon, and since epsilon is an arbitrary positive real, we have, it follows that A contains no sets of negative measure. Since we have A contains no measurable sets of measure less than minus epsilon, greater than minus epsilon, so we have that epsilon to be arbitrary positive, and it follows that clearly A contains no sets of negative measure, and we'll conclude that A must be positive set. So we have A to be a positive set, which where we got it to be A contains no measurable sets of measure less than epsilon minus epsilon, and also we have measure of A to be greater than zero. So this will complete the proof of the lemma.